There's a new fad sweeping the world of systems design. It's powerful, intelligent, robust, adaptive, and just might be the key to a bold new future. What is it? Why, it's none other than fuzzy logic, a new way of thinking about an old problem. Fuzzy logic-based systems have been growing in popularity in recent years, and nowadays fuzzy technology can even be found in some household appliances, like washing machines and rice cookers.
But what is fuzzy logic? Well, fuzzy logic is like Boolean logic, but more fuzzy. Instead of asserting that things are either on or off, or black or white, fuzzy logic asserts the shades of gray that exist between these traditionally binary facets.
Take the apple. Is something an apple, or is it not? It seems like an easy question, but it's actually more complicated than one might think at first glance. For example, say that I take a bite out of the apple. Is it still an apple? Obviously, right? But now say I take another, and another, until only half the apple is remaining. Is it still an apple now? What about when only the core remains? And what about when not even that remains? At one point, in other words, does the apple cease being an apple? In Boolean logic, we must assume there is a definite point where the apple crosses the line from being apple to not apple, but it's not clear where this point is. Fuzzy logic allows us to see the changing apple as partially an apple while it is still in the process of being eaten. So, now our whole apple is a 100% apple, and our half apple is a 50% apple. When the apple has been completely eaten, it is a 0% apple. With fuzzy logic, we embrace the shades of gray that allow an apple to go from whole to core.
The apple example illustrates how fuzzy logic allows us to break down a problem and view it in a way that makes more natural sense to people. This is not by accident. Fuzzy set theory was first proposed by the mathematician Lofty Zadeh in 1965, who felt that binary truth values were not only unintuitive, but also incomplete. Whereas something like 1 plus 1 equals 2 had an absolute immutable truth, there were some questions that had variable answers, like asking someone to tell the weather or identify a color. In other words, fuzzy logic is designed to approximate the way we people think when we approach a problem, like what color is this shirt? Similar problems exist everywhere in engineering, and by attempting to imitate human heuristics and thinking, fuzzy logic could allow us to engineer much more powerful systems.
As another example, think about when it is raining outside. When you go out and it is raining, you have to make a few decisions. Do I bring a raincoat? An umbrella? A computer might approach this problem by measuring the rainfall and attempting to track that to some kind of decision. Rainfall greater than, say, 4 centimeters a minute might track to take out your umbrella. But even though we humans are not capable of measuring rainfall with such precision, we can still make an intelligent decision that works for us, based on the combination of a number of factors. We make a snap decision based on the rain, the humidity, how far we have to go, whether we feel like running or walking, how much we mind getting our clothes wet, and so on. There is no complex system governing this decision, only a heuristic that we have built up through years and years of experience. A heuristic that recognizes the shades of gray between rainy and not rainy.
This is the true power of fuzzy systems. It's not just about having fun with a new kind of math, or giving somebody an apple with a bite out of it and saying here's a 93% apple. It's about the future of intelligent systems using fuzzy heuristics.
An airplane is one of the most complicated pieces of engineering of all time, and developing automated controls for one is a matter of great mathematical and engineering complexity. And yet, a pilot can learn how to fly an airplane, and even master it to perform complicated maneuvers that would make our most sophisticated autopilots break a sweat. It takes thousands of hours and a lot of hard work, but all the hardware is already there. If we could engineer a machine with that kind of power, then our future is truly unlimited.
Thank you for watching, and I hope you have a 100% great day.